Hello everyone, my name is Nikita, and I'm going to present our work on dense unsupervised learning for video segmentation. This is a joint work with Simona Schaubmeier and Stefan Roth.
The goal of this work is to perform video object segmentation. At test time, an initial annotation is provided for some reference frame. The annotation designates certain objects of interest, such as the biker and the motorcycle here. We have to densely track these objects in the subsequent frames, as the ground truth annotation here shows. This is a challenging problem, as can be seen in this example. The biker and the motorcycle both change in the relative view angle and the distance to the camera. The object motion can be arbitrarily fast and affect the degree of the pixel displacement. We need to learn a feature representation that is invariant to these changes, so we can track the objects reliably throughout the whole sequence. In our work, we learn such features in a completely unsupervised way. Instead of using ground truth annotation for training, as in many previous studies, we investigate how we can efficiently and effectively leverage the large unlabeled video datasets to learn such a representation. To date, we have ample amounts of such videos gathered from the public domain into datasets like YouTube VOS and Kinetics. For a start, we need to make some assumptions about the desired properties of the feature representations that we want to learn. First, we assume non-local feature diversity. This means that the semantic feature representations should be spatially distinguishable. Let us take an example of this frame extracted from a car racing video sequence. We discretize the image plane with an overimposed coarser feature grid typical to the fully convolutional neural networks. This first assumption implies that our feature representation extracted from one grid cell should be different from a feature from another cell, say in terms of the cosine distance. Natural images typically exhibit such property. This assumption has featured, for example, in the previous work by Jabri et al. Our second assumption is a more general variant of the temporal coherence. We want the features extracted from some frame in a video sequence to be closer to any other feature extracted from the same video, for example, in terms of the cosine distance, rather than a feature extracted from another video. This is a reasonable assumption, because the change in the scene appearance within a video is seldom as significant as between different video shots. Even though both examples here show a racing car scenario, the road surface is perceptibly distinguishable. Wang et al. Relied on this assumption in their implementation of a contrastive learning framework. The third assumption is the temporal persistence of semantic content. This means that the semantic content of the video clips remains unchanged, at least within a short time span. Taking an example of the racing car again, although the orientation and the position of the car with respect to the camera changes with time, semantically, these frames are not dissimilar. There is still the road and the racing car. A bit more technically, this means that if we extract a feature from one grid cell, we can find a semantically corresponding feature in the other, temporally close frames. This is in contrast to contrastive random walk approach by Jabri et al. That assumes every frame to contain the corresponding feature, which can be problematic due to occlusions. Consider the example of finding the correspondence to the road region at time step 0. While we can still find the corresponding road patch at time steps 10 and 20, the area becomes largely occluded by the car and the exhaust fumes at time step 30. This would still work under our assumption, as we merely assume at least one of the other frames to contain the corresponding feature, which is satisfied in this example. If we now attempt to implement these assumptions and learn a feature representation in a fully convolutional fashion, this will result in a degenerate or shortcut solution. In our preliminary experiments, we observed that the network will simply ignore the input and will learn, as we hypothesize, something akin to positional encoding. A similar observation was made in previous works, and is related to the fact that the commonly used implementations of the convolutional networks are not truly translation variant, for instance, due to the padding. In this work, we make another assumption that allows to avoid such trivial solutions. We assume that the features should be equivariant to similarity transformations, such as flipping and scaling. This assumption is valid for the task of video object segmentation, on which we focus in this work. A bit more technically, this means that the distance between two corresponding features in the two views should be closest with respect to all other possible pairs of the features. This assumption has not yet been exploited in prior work to learn semantic feature representations from videos in an unsupervised way. Let us summarize the novelty of our approach in the context of these assumptions. While assumptions 1 and 2 on the non-local feature diversity and the temporal coherence were studied independently in previous works, we investigate their combination in our work. We further introduce our occlusion-aware variant of assumption 3 on the temporal persistence of semantic content, and the yet unexplored assumption on equivariance. Uniting these assumptions in a novel framework, we find that we can efficiently and effectively learn dense semantic feature representations in a fully convolutional regime without falling prey to degenerate solutions. We implement our first three assumptions by performing unsupervised clustering as follows. First, we sample a video clip to generate two views where the second view is generated by applying a random similarity transform. Next, we select one of the frames in a video and designate it as the reference frame. We then select anchors that will represent cluster centers from this reference frame. These anchors are simply selected from the set of the feature vectors produced by a fully convolutional network. Note that these steps are performed for a number of video sequences in parallel, hence our collection of anchors will have origins in multiple video sequences. We compute the affinity of all features in the frames of the other time steps in both views with respect to these anchors. We define the affinity between the feature and an anchor as the softmax over cosine distances of that feature to all anchors, normalized by a hyperparameter tau. Now every v and v hat at a given cell location represents a distribution of possible assignments to the anchors akin to cluster assignments. We then select the dominant assignment over this distribution by the argmax operation. Note that the argmax is over the index set of the anchors belonging to the same video sequence. This is to satisfy our assumption 2 on the temporal coherence. This will generate pseudo-labels that represent the closest anchor to the given feature. We provide these pseudo-labels to the original first view transformed with the similarity transformation that we used before to spatially align the features. We minimize the distance of the features to the anchors with the corresponding assignment provided by the pseudo-labels. As a consequence of this cell supervision, first, the features from the same view will get attracted to the anchors of the reference frame, satisfying our assumption 3 on the temporal persistence. And second, implementing assumption 1, the anchors will be mutually repelled due to the softmax used in computing their affinities. Note that by exploiting the second view, we sidestep the degenerate solutions, since the trivial positional encoding would lead to inconsistent feature representation between the original and the transformed view. To further regularize the training, which is especially relevant when training on larger datasets, we ensure that the distance of the corresponding features between the two views satisfies our assumption on equivariance, assumption 4, that we introduced before. That is, the feature in the first view should have the closest counterpart in the corresponding location of the second view. We will formalize this shortly. We implement this idea with the following framework. It contains two computational branches, the main and the regularizing branch. We use multiple series of the original frames, corresponding to different video clips and denoted here in different color, as the input to the main branch, and generate a random similarity transform in the regularizing branch. We pass both inputs through a shared feature extractor to produce a 3D space-time feature tensors, k and k hat. We then sample the anchors on a uniform grid from the spatial tensor in the main branch. Using a sparse sampling grid for the anchors reduces the memory footprint and, as we show empirically in our paper, also improves the segmentation accuracy. This sampling takes place only from the feature tensor corresponding to a single video frame selected uniformly at random from each video clip. We compute the cosine distance between all features in both branches with respect to the anchors. Next, we select dominant assignments to these anchors in the regularizing branch and provide those to supervise the assignment in the main branch. This is ensured by the standard cross-entropy laws. Similarly, we compute the cross-view consistency by also sampling the features from the regularizing branch on a uniform grid. Note that the features in both the main and the regularizing branches are spatially aligned here with the help of the similarity transformation that we use to generate the input to the regularizing branch. We compute the cosine distance between the corresponding features in both views. The second, cross-view loss, minimizes the relative distance between these corresponding features with respect to the distances of the non-corresponding pairs by means of the cross entropy. We add this loss term to the main loss described previously with a small trade-off factor. We tested our approach by training on a number of commonly used video datasets and compared to previous work that used the same dataset for training. As evaluation metrics, we used the standard Jacquard's index for the region similarity and the F measure for the contact quality. We first trained on TrackingNet and compared to the work by Wang et al., which used patch-level tracking to obtain positive pairs for contrastive learning. We significantly improved over this work by 6.4% mean J and F score. When trained on kinetics, we compared to the contrastive random walk approach by Jabri et al., which relies on the time cycle consistency. We improved their result by 1.1%. Trained on a smaller dataset, YouTube VOS, we compared to MAST, an approach that uses an image reconstruction objective. Our approach not only significantly improves over this work, but is also on par with the results obtained from much larger datasets. This suggests that our approach is more data efficient. Qualitatively, we observe that our method learns feature representations that are robust to ID switches between the tracked objects, as the example with a playing dog on the right here. In the same vein, the learned features exhibit more robustness in establishing semantic relationships between temporally distant frames, as can be visible from the segmentation of the dancer's torso. Our learned feature representation is also robust to large motion and drastic background changes. This is despite the fact that our method here was trained on a much smaller dataset and required significantly fewer training iterations. In detail, our approach exhibits improved training efficiency compared to previous work. Regardless of the training data we use, our approach requires fewer training iterations to converge, sometimes needing just a fraction of the training time of the previous works. For example, our approach trains more than 3 times faster than the contrastive random walk approach. Moreover, our framework has a lower memory footprint and can be trained efficiently on just a single commodity GPU. To summarize, we presented an unsupervised approach to learning dense feature representations. We formalized and integrated the assumptions on the feature diversity and the temporal coherence that were previously used only in isolation. We added the assumption on temporal persistence that is conceptually more robust to occlusions than in previous work. Finally, we exploited model equivariance to similarity transformations. As the outcome of combining these assumptions, we have proposed an unsupervised framework that allows to learn dense feature representations in a fully convolutional manner and avoids degenerate solutions, which has not been possible before. Trained without any supervision, our framework achieves state-of-the-art video object segmentation accuracy compared to previous work. This holds even if we use significantly less data and is consistent across training and testing scenarios. Moreover, our approach is also more computationally efficient, in some scenarios substantially so, than in previous work. It exhibits fast training convergence and lower computational and memory footprint. The code and pre-trained models are publicly available, and we hope you find it useful in your work. I would like to close by acknowledging the support of this work from the European Research Council and LERVA Initiative. Thank you for watching.